Welcome everyone. In this Type With Me tutorial, I'll basically teach you how to make a Hello World server. So what this server is actually going to do is it's going to wait for clients, and when a client connects to it, it's going to send the string Hello World back to the client. A very simple server. This is just to illustrate how to go about the programming itself. I'm going to type each of the lines, so please try and follow. So first is of course the includes. We'll fill in rest of the includes a little later. So what we need is of course a socket. So let's try to first break up as to what we are going to do. We are going to take a TCP socket first, bind that socket to a particular port, and wait for clients. Once we get a client, we are going to send out the message Hello World to the client and then close the connection, right? The server structure is for the server itself to bind to a particular port on the local machine, and the client structure would be returned by accept when a client connects to us. So let's move down here. So this is something which you remember from the presentation, the way in which we initialize socket. Now note that the socket call, this is wrong, I cannot give the same name. So note that the socket call would return -1 if there was an error. So we need to do a little bit of error checking as well. So let's try and enclose this in an if statement and check if soc is -1. If it is -1, then there is an error, and then we can use p error to find out what the problem is. And of course, because we couldn't get a socket, it's better to exit, right? So our socket has been made here. Now the question is, what are the includes for socket, etc.? So for that, let's flip to a new window and do a man socket. So this tells us that sys_types.h and sys_socket.h is what is required. So let's quickly go up. Also for the structures, need this. Okay, coming back. Now basically we feed in the server socketddr_instructure with all the port number, IP address, etc. So first is the family, which in this case is af_inet. And let's say the port number. Remember that because the port number is 2 bytes and we have to put everything in network byte order, we'll have to change the byte ordering from host byte order to network byte order. This we do by using htones, host to network short. Now we give any port number. Let's say we use 10,000 for the server process in this example. Now we give the IP address the server should bind to. what an ADDR underscore any means that this server should bind to all available interfaces on the local machine, which would be, let's say, ETH 0 and LO for just a single homed machine. Now, basically for padding, we'll have to zero off the rest of the structure. And for easy understanding, that's even called sin underscore zero. We know it's 8 bytes long. So once we have done this, what we have to do is call bind. Now, we could quickly look at the man for bind. It's actually the second section. So bind takes in a socket and the address structure which we just created and address length. So what you can do is, let's mention another variable here called int, right? Let's say keep it simple, len. And now we basically find out the length of the sock addr underscore in structure. So now once again we'll have to do a little bit of error checking for bind also. So let's put bind inside this. Bind would also return minus one if there is an error. So we put in the socket here. Now because bind requires a structure of form sock addr, and which we've seen, you know, is the superstructure having just the family and the data as in our presentation, we'll have to cast the addr underscore in structure to that. Note, a pointer to it is required, which means, now we give the server's address. So now we have a pointer cast to sock addr star type. And then finally, we give the length. We check once again for an error. If there is any error, we are going to print it out. Also note that for P error, we'll need to include, I think, erno.h, or is it error.h? It's erno.h, right? So actually this is the way in which, even if you forget which are the include files, could go about finding them. So once we are bound, we know that we have to listen for a particular number of connections. So once again we do our error checking and call listen. Listen once again on the socket. Let's say we allow 5 pending connections of clients to be there at the very maximum. Normally listen would not give any error at all, but just to be on the safe side, I think we've made a mistake with a bracket here. Okay. Fine, it's okay. Once again, a P error for listen. And exit if there is an error. So once we are listening, what we have to do is we have to wait for various connections. Now once a client connects to us, we receive that connection and start processing. Now to do this, let's just create a while one loop. It's a bad way of doing it because the only way the server can now exit is with a control C or